नमस्कार, स्वागत है आप सभी का पीएमई विद्या चैनल में। आपके साथ मैं हूं मुक्ता कांडियाल और आप देख रहे हैं हमारा ये लाइव इंटरैक्टिव सेशन। और हम हाजिर हैं मैथमेटिक्स के अपनी इस क्लासरूम के साथ कक्षा 9वीं के छात्रों के लिए। आज का हमारा ये सत्र है, तो आप हमारे ये कार्यक्रम पीएम विद्या के चैनल नंबर 9 पर इस वक्त लाइव देख रहे हैं। और जो एक्सपर्ट आज हमारे साथ जुड़ी हैं, जो आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 3, उसे हम कंटिन्यू करेंगे। और जो एक्सपर्ट आज हमारे साथ जुड़ी हुई हैं वो है मिसेस बीना प्रकाश मैम, सीनियर पीजीटी मैथमेटिक्स एट कैंपियन स्कूल भोपाल। नमस्कार बीना मैम, बहुत बहुत स्वागत है आपका इस सत्र में।
गुड आफ्टरनून, अ हैप्पी डे टू यू ऑल।
थैंक यू मैम। और मैं अपने सभी दर्शकों से कहना चाहूंगी कि आप, जैसे कि मैंने अभी बताया, आप हमारा ये कार्यक्रम पीएम विद्या के चैनल नंबर 9 पर इस वक्त लाइव देख रहे हैं। तो यदि आपके किसी भी तरह के प्रश्न हो, किसी भी तरह की क्वेरीज आपके सत्र के लिए हो, तो आप हमें फोन करके पूछ सकते हैं। हमारा फोन नंबर है 8800440559। आप चाहें तो ईमेल के द्वारा भी अपने प्रश्नों को हम तक पहुँचा सकते हैं। ईमेल एड्रेस इस वक्त आपकी टेलीविजन स्क्रीन पर फ्लैश हो रही है। और चलिए बिना किसी देरी के आज का ये सत्र हम शुरू करते हैं। बीना मैम की तरफ रुक करते हैं। मैम, क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 3 आज हम पढ़ने वाले हैं, यानी कि पार्ट 2 और पार्ट 1 हम अपने पिछले सत्रों में कवर कर चुके हैं। तो सत्र शुरू करने से मैम एक क्विक रीकैप हमारे स्टूडेंट्स के लिए आप दे दें तो बेहतर रहेगा मैम।
हाँ जी, हमने लास्ट दो क्लासेस में क्या किया था, हमने क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स के बारे में देखा था। सो इन क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स, व्हाट इज क्वाड्रिलेटरल? इट्स अ फोर साइडेड क्लोज्ड फिगर। बट व्हाट in particular in quadrilateral, we took different types of quadrilateral. So the very first thing that we took was trapezoid, trapezium jisko bolte hai aap. Usme kya tha, that it had one pair of opposite sides parallel. Now if both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel, it's known as a parallelogram. Every parallelogram has a property. The properties of parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other, opposite angles are equal, opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. So ye ki cheez kiya tha humne parallelogram mein. Then we went to another type of parallelogram, that is a, with a particular condition, that is if suppose all sides of the parallelogram are equal, then it is known as a rhombus. And if each angle measures 90 degree, then it is known as a rectangle. A rectangle with all sides equal is known as a square. So these are the types of quadrilaterals we discussed in the last class, and we took certain properties of all. Now we move ahead. Hum thoda sa hatke karenge. There is another theorem that we need to do, that is known as midpoint theorem. Now here I'll read out the statement. The statement says, the line joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and it is half of it. So let's see this line joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. There are two triangle sides, AB and AC. Am I audible? Is it clear?
Yes ma'am, you are completely audible. Yes ma'am.
Now P is the midpoint of the side AB. Likewise, Q is also the midpoint of side AC. हमें क्या प्रूव करना है कि the line which joins these two midpoints is actually parallel to the third side. Third side अब क्या हुआ? BC. And also, not just parallel, it is half of it. So these are the two things that you need to prove. So how is it proved? We prove it through the construction. There is a construction, that is, we'll draw a line CR which is parallel to AB. We'll draw CR. Can you see this line CR? C to R. This particular line, this is parallel to BP, this side, AB. And then what we do is, we have already made a line segment PQ. Humne join kiya tha na midpoints. We have already made it. What we do is, we extend it. PQ ko hum extend karenge such that it gets intersected with the line, the parallel line CR. So we do intersect at this point R. So we have joined, extended PQ to CR. So then there are two constructions. One is to draw parallel to AB, CR parallel to AB, then to extend PQ to R such that it gets intersected with CR. So with this construction, we move ahead. Now what do we start with? Actually, what are we trying to prove? That we try to prove that this PQ is parallel to BC. Now when will PQ be parallel to BC? ये हमें देखा, हमें स्टार्ट कैसे करना है? वी एक्चुअली नीड टू प्रूव दैट पी आर इज पैरेलल टू बी सी, है ना? अब आप देखिए, पी आर पैरेलल टू बी सी, आपको एक क्वाड्रिलैटरल दिख रहा है, पी बी सी आर, दैट्स अ क्वाड्रिलैटरल। अब ये क्वाड्रिलैटरल पैरेललोग्राम बन जाए अगर, तो हमारा काम हो जाएगा, द ऑपोजिट साइड्स बी सी एंड पी आर विल बी पैरेलल। So what we are trying to prove is they make a parallelogram, that is the PRCB, the quadrilateral we have is a parallelogram. So prove karne ke liye what we'll do is, we start with this triangle APQ and QRC. Isme hame ek information hai na, already AQ and QC are equal. And now look at this angle, BAC. BAC makes this angle. And angle RCA, it is this angle. How are they formed? Are they not formed through these two parallel lines where AC acts as a, this is, we have a line transversal which intersects the two parallel lines. Hence, what do these pair of angles form? We have first, second chapter of geometry mein padha tha, lines and angles mein. They form a pair of alternate angles. ये दोनों एक दूसरे के alternate है, provided they are parallel. So they are alternate angles, and these alternate angles will be equal only when these two lines are parallel. So वो लिखा मैंने angle A is parallel equal to angle QCR by construction. What does this mean? हमने बनाया है ना CR parallel to AB. So that gives us this angle BAC. And angle ACR, they will be equal. And this angle AQP and CQR, AQP and CQR, they are already equal. They are vertically opposite angles. Do elements milke hame is triangle ke. Now we look for, again recollect. Ye bachcho yaad hoga aap logon ko, humne triangles mein kiya tha, congruence. So we have two angles. With two angles, what is the other element that we require? It could be another, either S or AAS. That means we need to fix in one side between the two angles or besides the two angles to get the congruence. So, aapko kya dikh raha hai? We have this side equal to this side. So, isn't it angle, side, angle? So, why are the two triangles congruent? That's congruent because of the congruence we have ASC. So, once the two triangles are congruent, we find that the remaining elements of these two triangles will also be equal. What are the remaining elements? The side AP, side CR, they will be equal. Side AP and side CR, they will be equal. That is what I have written here. Check it. And then we also have this side PQ equal to QR. They will also be equal. Apart from that, we also have these two angles also equal. So there are all the remaining elements are now been proved. So we get now the two triangles are congruent. Now what is required? Let us go further. Hame kya chahiye? We require AP and C. This is AP is equal to CR. We have got AP is equal to CR. Now what is AP equal to? Isn't it equal to PB? Because P is the midpoint of AB. P happens to be the midpoint of AB. So AP and PB are equal. And we prove that AP and CR are equal. So what relation do we get? AP and CR will also be equal. So now we come to this quadrilateral PBCR. अब आप देखिए ध्यान से PBCR को, इसमें we find that one pair of opposite side is parallel as well as equal. देखिए PB is parallel to CR as well as equal. अभी हमने प्रूव किया है. So what conclusion do we have? This quadrilateral will be a parallelogram. So we have proved that the side PQ will be parallel to, because the other pair of opposite side will also be parallel. So that's what we have. And then the next result that we need, the opposite sides are equal also. So what is that opposite side? PR and BC, that's equal. PR and BC, that's equal. But we also got the proof that PQ and QR is equal. Now PQ and QR equal. Now I'm taking PR in terms of PQ. If PR is divided at Q in two equal halves, and we can rewrite this as twice of PQ. So twice of PQ is equal to BC, that gives us PQ is equal to half of BC. So this is how we prove the first theorem, that is the sides joining the midpoints of two sides will be parallel as well as the half the third side. Now the converse of it, that's a line drawn through the midpoint of one side of the triangle parallel to the other side. We are making a line segment PQ, which happens to be such that P is the midpoint of side AB and it is a line which is parallel to BC. PQ is a line which is parallel to B. Then what we need to prove that AQ and QC are equal. That is, it is going to pass through the midpoint of the third side. So this is the converse of the previous. Iska bhi abhi same cheez hai construction. I'll be constructing CR, constructed CRT parallel to BA and then extended PQ to R. Ab aap dekhiye, CR is parallel to PB because of the construction. And PQ is parallel to BC. It's already given. This is repeated statement of the previous. This is a correction. Yeah, PQ is parallel to BC. So what do we get about this quadrilateral PRCB? PRC now becomes a parallelogram. That is because both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So it's now a parallelogram. So now again, parallelogram means all both the sides are equal. Now let's consider the triangle APQ and CQR. APQ and CQR, we are considering these two triangles. This angle is vertically opposite to this and angle A is equal to angle C with the same relation, that is they are parallel. And what else do we have? We have AP is equal to CR. AP is equal to CR is equal to PB because P is the midpoint. So we have AP is equal to BP is already equal to CR because it's a parallelogram. No, if parallelogram ka opposite sides are equal, so PB will be equal to CR. But hamara PB kiski equal hai? AP ki equal hai because P is the midpoint of AB. So we have this relation, that is AP is equal to CR. So don't we have the two triangles congruence by AAS? Hence, the element, as I said, the remaining elements are also equal. That is, AQ is equal to CQ. So we have proved that if a line which is there, which is passing through the midpoint of one side parallel to the second side, will pass through the midpoint of the third side. So we have these two theorems. With the help of these two theorems, we'll be doing certain questions. Start with the first question of the exercise. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which PQRS are the midpoints of these sides. You have to prove that SR is parallel to AC and SR is half of AC. Likewise, PQ is equal to SR, or in short, PQRS is a parallelogram. All these three results has to be proved. Again, how is it done? I've joined this A and C and divided this quadrilateral into two triangles. I've considered it as two triangle ADC and ABC. Now, this triangle, mein, what do we find? S is the midpoint of AD, R is the midpoint of DC. So, isn't SR a line which is joining the midpoints of two sides? Yes. So, hence, what relation do we have? SR is parallel to the third side AC and it will also be half of it. So, humne ye result prove kar liya isse. Now, likewise, you take up the other triangle. Ab ye triangle hum le lete, ABC. ABC. This triangle mein we find the similar condition. P is the midpoint of AB, Q is the midpoint of BC. So, line segment PQ is the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides, hence it will be parallel and half the third side. That is, PQ is also parallel. PQ is equal to half of AC as well as PQ is parallel to AC. Ab aap ye dono result dekhiye. SR parallel to AC, PQ parallel to AC. So Euclid's axiom, dhyan rakhiye, same are equal to a same, so they will be equal to each other. So SR parallel to PQ. Similarly here, SR half of PQ, AC hai, PQ is half of AC. We get SR equal to PQ. So again, a pair of opposite sides equal and parallel, this quadrilateral becomes a parallelogram. So all the three conditions have been satisfied. So whenever we get joined the midpoints of any quadrilateral and a quadrilateral is formed, then that quadrilateral will always be a parallelogram. You can take it as a rule. So, now, next question that we have is again based on this only, that is ABC now. ABCD is a rhombus. अब PQRS आर द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ द साइड्स AB, BC, CD एंड रेस्पेक्टिवली यू हैव टू शो दैट दिस क्वाड्रिलैटरल सो फॉर्मड इज अ रेक्टेंगल. Now, rectangle means it's a particular type of parallelogram. So first we need to prove that PQRS is a parallelogram. So ab aap dhyan se dekhiye, PQRS, they are the midpoints of the sides of the quadrilateral. So a quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints, won't it be a parallelogram? Abhi just now humne kiya tha na, ki PQRS is now a parallelogram. तो हमारे पास फर्स्ट कंडीशन क्या है कि क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स फॉर्म बाय जॉइनिंग द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. देयरफॉर PQRS बिकम्स अ पैरेललोग्राम. नाउ व्हाट डू वी गेट फ्रॉम हियर? वी नीड टू प्रूव दैट इट्स अ रेक्टेंगल. सो हाउ डू वी प्रूव इट? व्हेन वी हैव द पैरेललोग्राम रेक्टेंगल्स, ये प्रॉपर्टीज हमें याद रखना चाहिए बच्चों. देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स दैट वी हैव इन रेक्टेंगल. The diagonals, they bisect each other, क्योंकि वो parallelogram का property है. Fine, the diagonals, they are equal in length for a rectangle. So अगर एक parallelogram में if the diagonals of the parallelogram are equal, then that parallelogram will always be a rectangle. So हमारे target ये है कि हम prove करें this diagonal AC, PR and QS, they are equal. इसके लिए हमने क्या क्या देखे? AD is equal to AD, the side AD of the rhombus and BC of the rhombus. They are equal opposite sides of a parallelogram. They are equal. So, uska half and opposite, they are parallel also. I have taken both the relation. So, un dono ka half lene se kya milega aapko? AS and BQ. AS and BQ are AS are equal as well as parallel. So, what does this quadrilateral ASQB? ASQB, ये quadrilateral क्या बन जाएगा? The line, again, देखिए, एक pair of opposite sides, they are equal as well as parallel, therefore this becomes a parallelogram. So if it becomes a parallelogram, don't you have this relation? That is AB, side AB. Side AB जो है, is equal to side QS, because the next, the other pair of opposite sides will also be equal as well as parallel. So we need only the equality. So we have this AB is equal to QS. Likewise, we can always find that AD and PR are also equal. Now AD and PR equal, AB and QS equal. Now how are they connected? We have AB equal to AD. Why are they equal? Because ABCD is a rhombus. It's the rhombus. So therefore, the adjacent sides of this quadrilateral or parallelogram, they are equal. So we have AB and AD equal. So we get QS and PR equal. So QS and PR happens to be the diagonals of this parallelogram PQRS. हमने तो पहले प्रूव कर दिया था parallelogram. अब we have their diagonals are equal. Then that becomes a rectangle. So that's what we have as the next question. This is another very important question. This says that we have, the question says that ABC is a right angle triangle, right angle at C. It is right angle at C. A line through the midpoint of M, a line through the midpoint of M, that is hypotenuse of midpoint during the M, and parallel to BC. It is parallel. Line we are drawing parallel to BC. Intersect AC at D. So you have to show all these results. This result say that MD line is perpendicular to AC. CM, this is EA, CM is equal to MA is equal to MB. Actually, this should have been MB. Now, our open first task dekhte. D is midpoint of AC. How do we prove that D will be the midpoint of AC? याद करके देखिए भी सेकंड थ्योरम रिवर्स कन्वर्स ऑफ द फर्स्ट मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम देखा ना हमने. अ लाइन पासिंग थ्रू मिड पॉइंट ऑफ वन साइड पैरेलल टू सेकंड साइड विल पास थ्रू द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द थर्ड साइड. ये किया था ना हमने सेकंड कन्वर्स थ्योरम. सो व्हाट इज दैट सेइंग? कि वी हैव एडी एंड डीसी आर इक्वल. एडी एंड डीसी आर इक्वल. सो वी हैव दिस इज AD equal to DC. Fine. Now the next theorem, that is angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. Angle 1 and angle 2 is 180 degree. ये भी हमने कहाँ देखा था? the pair of these are two pairs of parallel lines, and DC is a transversal. So these two forms a pair of interior angles which adds up to 180 degree. Right? So if they add up to 180 degree, what relation do we have between angle 2 and angle 1? Angle 1 is already, angle 2 is already 90 degree. This is already 90 degree. So what will the measure of angle 1 be? Therefore, angle 1 will be 90 degree. Okay? Itna clear ho raha hai, Mukta ji? Angle 1 becomes 90 degree. So we have this relation, that is MD is perpendicular to AC. Yahan tak clear hua hai, Mukta ji?
Bilkul, ma'am.
Ha, now, abhi dekhiye, last part of this. We have ki ye jo side hai, the last thing of this side. Ab dhyan se dekhiye, this is CM and MA and MB. CM, we need to join. Let us join it. CM, let's join this. Ye CM and AM and MB. All these three sides are equal. How do we prove it? How do we prove this, that they are equal? Ab aap dekhiye, what is MD? MD jo hai, it is perpendicular to AC. AC ka perpendicular hai. And what else do we have? D is the midpoint of AC. So what is this line MD? Isn't it the perpendicular bisector of AC? It's a perpendicular bisector of AC. So we again have a property. What is it? Any point on the perpendicular bisector is equidistant from the end point, that is A and C. So our result aa gaya. What does it say? This point M will be equidistant from A as well as C. So we have that relation, that is AM is equal to CM. Now what is AM? AM is the midpoint of AB. So we can treat it as half of AB, or that is equal to MB. So this is what you have as the next question. Right? So we have the next question as, show that the line segments joining the midpoints of the opposite sides of a quadrilateral bisect each other. Ab hamare paas ye quadrilateral hai ABCD. Now is quadrilateral ABCD ko join, midpoints join karte hue hum ek quadrilateral bana rahe hain PQRS. We draw this, make this quadrilateral PQRS. Now what do we have this quadrilateral as? PQRS. Are they not the midpoints of the sides of the quadrilateral ABCD? Hence, what is the PQRS are midpoints of sides. So, therefore, what does that imply? PQRS will always be a parallelogram. Okay? Now, after this, what we need to prove? That the quadrilaterals, they bisect each other. Aapko ye prove karna hai ki the side PR and QS, they are bisecting each other. So how do we prove it? Abhi humne dikha hai, humne property dekha hai apanne. What is that property? Any quadrilateral which is a parallelogram has its diagonals bisecting each other. That's a property of a parallelogram. For any parallelogram, for any parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. The diagonals bisect each other. So, don't you have the result? Again, at the result, PO is equal to OR and OS is equal to QS. So, don't we have this result? So, humne in short kya kiya hai? We have proved that in any quadrilateral, if a quadrilateral is formed by the joining the midpoints of the sides of a quadrilateral, then that quadrilateral will be a parallelogram. And in particular, what else did we do? Agar humne koi particular quadrilateral parallelogram liya, jaise rhombus liya hai. Agar humne rhombus ke midpoints ko join karke parallelogram banaya hai, then that particular parallelogram will be a rectangle. Likewise, अगर आपने rectangle को किया है, rectangle ko join karte uske midpoint ko jayenge, then it will be a square. So these are the things that we have discussed in this chapter. So that's all we have in the chapter of quadrilateral. We started with parallelogram and then we had the final, that is midpoint theorem. Abhi tak koi doubt aaya hai kya Mukta ji? Class mein kisi bachon ko?
Nahi ma'am, Veena ma'am.
Hello.
Nahi Veena ma'am, abhi tak koi doubt nahi aaya hello. Hello. Veena ma'am, abhi tak to koi doubt hamare viewers students ki taraf se.
Haan, ab aap.
Bilkul. मैं कह रही थी वीना मैम, अभी तक तो कोई डाउट हमारे स्टूडेंट्स की तरफ से नहीं आया. लगता है कि आज का जो हमारा सेशन था क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 3 पैरेललोग्राम्स और मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम जो आपने आज के सेशन में पढ़ाई में समझ से हमारे स्टूडेंट्स को अच्छे तरीके से समझ आ गई है. इसी वजह से कोई भी डाउट्स आज हमारी तरफ से कोई स्टूडेंट्स की तरफ से कोई रेज नहीं हुआ. वीना मैम, सेशन समाप्त करने से पहले मेरा आपसे ये प्रश्न होगा, क्या क्या इसका कोई पार्ट 4 भी रहेगा? ये जो फिर हमारा क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स का ये जो पार्ट चैप्टर
है ये हो गया. दिस इज खत्म. दैट्स द लास्ट थिंग दैट वी हैव इन दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल.
ओके,
वी हैव डन दैट क्वाड्रिलेटरल.
ओके, थैंक यू सो मच वीना मैम देन फॉर ज्वाइनिंग विद अस. और इतना अच्छा सेशन जो आज का था हमारा क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 3, और जितने भी आपने कॉन्सेप्ट आज हमारे स्टूडेंट्स के लिए डिलीवर करे उसके लिए एक बार फिर से धन्यवाद. मैं अपने स्टूडेंट्स जितने भी व्यूअर्स हमारे साथ जुड़े रहे उनका भी धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगी. आप हमारे साथ जुड़े, हमारा ये कार्यक्रम देखा. अब फिलहाल हम इस सत्र को यहीं पर समाप्त करें, लेकिन जल्द हाजिर होंगे अपने अगले सत्र के साथ. जुड़े रहिए पीएम विद्या चैनल और एनसीईआरटी ऑफिशियल से. मुझे दीजिए इजाजत. नमस्कार.